Hello everyone, to help you more conveniently in using IC Markets products. In this video, I will guide you on how to use the MetaTrader 4 platform from IC Markets. In the first part of this guide, I will show you how to download the software, log into your account on the MetaTrader 4 platform, and introduce you to the main toolbars of this platform that we need to know when we use it.
Welcome to the IB Support Channel. This is an information channel that guides about the IC Markets floor. If you are new to IC Markets, please subscribe to the channel to receive the most useful information on the IC Markets floor.
To download the MetaTrader 4 trading platform, please log into your client area, go to the IC Markets homepage, select Client Login. In this login section, enter your email address and password. Then click Login. Next, in this client area, pay attention to the column on the left. Select Downloads. And here you go. Scroll down and you will see that we have the MetaTrader 4 platform here. And it has many small tabs. You will leave the first tab. Next, select Download MT4. After that, you will choose where to save this trading platform. Next, select Save. So the trading platform has been downloaded. I will click on it to install it. Installing MetaTrader 4 is very easy. You just need to double-click on the installer. Then click Next and you will install this package. A finish notification like this means we have finished installing. Click Finish. Next, it will automatically launch the MetaTrader 4 platform. Here it directs us to the website QLN5 like this. This is the interface of the MetaTrader 4 platform when it first launches. It will display the Open an Account window. We will close this. We will use the account that we previously created in the client area. We will not create a new account using the interface here. If you do not know how to create a new trading account on the IC Markets platform, you can refer to the account opening guide videos that the team has posted on the channel. For example, here I have a trading account on the MetaTrader 4 platform that I created before. This is just information for a demo account. However, for a live trading account, it is exactly the same. We will need these three pieces of information to log into the MetaTrader 4 trading platform. For login information, we need three things. One is the login ID, the account ID, right? The second is the account password. And the third is the account server. So on this trading platform, you will notice on the left there is the navigator bar. If you have closed this navigator bar before, you can make it reappear by clicking this button or by pressing the Ctrl+N keyboard shortcut. You can also go to view and select navigator, and this bar will appear. And when this bar appears, you will see it has account. Right click on it and select login to trade account. Then this window will appear. You will go to the account information section. Copy the account ID and paste it into the login section. Next, copy the password and paste it into the password section. After that, check which server this account belongs to. Here it is, IC Markets Demo 01. So I will also select this server, which is IC Markets Demo 01. After checking the information above, I will click Login. When we successfully log in, the account information will appear on the left like this, and in the section below. If you select the Trade tab, it will display the account balance information. On the chart above, this button also flashes, meaning that we can proceed to execute buy and sell orders on the trading products. With this trading platform, we can log into many different accounts. If you want to log in to additional accounts, you just need to go to the account section, right click and select login to trade account, and you can enter information for other accounts here. And note that when entering new account information, keep save account information checked like this. Then when we have a list of accounts here, when we want to log back into an account, we just need to double click on that account, then click login, and that account will be logged in because it has already saved the information. All right. And next, I will introduce you to the main toolbars of this MetaTrader 4 platform that we need to know when we use it. Here I will zoom in on this chart so you can see it more clearly. You see that the interface here is quite messy and hard to see. I will guide you on the setup in the next content. The toolbars of this platform that we need to pay attention to are as follows. First is the timeframe bar. This timeframe bar we will use to select different timeframes. Timeframe means time period, right? So currently here it is H4. I will switch to D1, which is daily, then W1, which is weekly, and MN, which is monthly. These M frames are minute frames. M is short for minute. Right, so when we are on the H1 frame, for example, each candle is formed after 1 hour. On the H4 frame, each candle will be formed after 4 hours. Similarly, D1 is the daily frame, W1 is the weekly frame, and MN is the monthly frame. And these are the corresponding minutes, 30 minutes. The second toolbar we need to pay attention to is this bar. The line study bar. This bar will provide us with tools that we can draw on the chart to help us identify market trends. For example, we have this line, which is the trend line. So you can draw a trend line like this to see if the market is in an uptrend or a downtrend. Right, then we also have horizontal lines, vertical lines. So here it will help us to mark different price levels or mark these candles corresponding to a specific time point to see how the market moved at that time. If you want to delete them, you just need to double click and right click, then click delete. In addition, we also have Fibonacci here, or we can write text on the screen. There are many other symbols here, like time up or the up arrow, down arrow. You can also have options for these toolbars by right clicking on them and selecting customize. There you can completely move additional functional tabs from the hidden column to the displayed column here. So you see that the displayed columns here will appear on the toolbar we are looking at. While on this side, they are hidden. Right, for example, I will move this one over. I click insert, and you will see it appears on this bar. The third toolbar we need to pay attention to is this bar. The chart bar. This bar will help us set up the screen display here. For example, you can click here to display 4 chart frames. You can click here to shift the chart to the left to make it easier to see the candles at the end. You can also zoom in and out of the screen, or you can adjust the display here to choose what type of candle it is, or display as a line chart. This is a Japanese candlestick chart, etc. In general, the chart section will be the support for screen display settings. The next toolbar is this bar, the standard bar. This standard bar will support us so we can display bars like this. For example, Market Watch or Navigator or Toolbox here. Toolbox is a bar that helps us see open trading orders, trading history, or what is this? This is our account equity as well as the fluctuations in the account when we have trading orders. We already know that Navigator will be a bar that helps us manage trading accounts. Here it also has additional indicator sections, which will support us in bringing up this chart to determine market trends. Or there can be trading robots. This market watch section is the section that will display the trading products that the broker provides for the account type we have here. So you can right click here and select show all, and you will see that there are many different products. In addition, there are some other functions, but they are rarely used. Basically, in the standard section, we use Market Watch, Navigator, and Toolbox. Some other things like these are very rarely used, so we don't need to pay too much attention to them. It also has this button, which is the New Order button, so we can execute new trading orders. You click here and you can set the trading volume, set the stop loss and take profit levels, and then we execute buy, sell orders. So those are some things we need to pay attention to. Basically, there are only 4 main toolbars, so those are enough functions for us to manage our account and to make money with this trading platform. And I will end this video here. In the next video, I will guide you on how to set up the screen display so that we have the clearest screen possible. And I will guide you on how to set up templates to help you quickly bring up many different sets of tools on the display screen without much effort to set them up. And remember to subscribe to the channel to get the latest information when the channel releases new content.